Hello everyone, in this video we are going to discuss an important topic, Hermite theory of beta decay. This question is very important from the examination point of view for degree 3 students. So we start. First of all, we will see who developed this theory and what is the purpose. See here, Enrico Fermi developed a theory for allowed beta decay. Fermi theory is based on the interaction of nucleon in the nucleus with the electron-neutron neutrino field. Okay, the nucleon follows a transition from one to another state, neutron into proton and vice versa. The transition results in the formation of an electron and antineutron. Now, what we are going to do? Actually, we will use quantum theory. And as you are aware that, according to perturbation theory in quantum mechanics, the probability of transition from one initial state to another final state is given by P is equal to 2 pi by h mod integration psi f asterisk h operator psi I d tau whole square and dn by dt 0 times dn by dt 0. So one by one you can see here, this is psi I. What is this? This is the initial state, wave function of the initial state. What is here? Psi f, it is the wave function of the final states. But you can see asterisk, this represents the conjugate, complex conjugate. Here I have written the asterisk represent the complex conjugate. Okay. Now this is operator. Okay. And d tau here. Dn by dt 0 is the energy density of final states. Dn by dt 0 is the energy density of final state. It is also known as a statistical factor, which we will calculate or derive later on its value actually. Now psi I is equal to psi n I. Here n, wave function of the initial state of the nucleus. Psi I, as I told you earlier, it is the initial wave function of the initial state, but it is equal to wave function for the initial state of nucleus. And psi f, psi f here, psi nf psi nu psi beta, psi nf is again the wave function for the final state of the nucleus. This is initial state of the nucleus. Psi neutron, psi nu and psi beta are the wave function of the electron and the neutron respectively. If in the first approximation we neglect the distortion of electron wave function due to presence of charge on the nucleus, then we can treat the wave function as plane wave. So under this condition, we can treat the wave function as the plane wave, and the normalization of wave function is written as. Normalization of wave function is written as psi beta asterisk psi beta d tau is equal to 1. This gives the normalization constant 1 by V half. What is V? V is the volume occupied by the free particle. And psi beta is equal to this much. The neutrino also interact with the matter very weakly. Hence, the wave function can again be treated as a plane wave. So, this equation 5, which is for beta or electron, here I am writing the same thing for neutrino. Okay, so this is psi nu, where here you can see the two symbols p beta p nu. P beta and p nu. P is the symbol of momentum. So p beta and p nu are the momentum of beta particle and neutron. P beta and p nu do not change appreciably within the nucleus, and also that electron and neutron have momenta of the order of m0c. That is why we can write here p nu almost equal to p beta almost equal to m0c, and p is equal to what? This one, we actually here you can see R0, new term, R0. This R0 is the radius of the nucleus. Okay. R0 is the radius of the nucleus. The discussion, this discussion allows us to take electron and neutrino wave function at r is equal to 0, and we have psi beta 0 psi nu 0 is equal to 1 by p. This is your equation 7. The equation 1 suggests that magnitude of probability depends on the form of the operator. Here Fermi suggested for it in simplest form equal to constant g. So here I am introducing a new letter g, which is a constant, and this can be written as, and finally it is g by v m I m. Okay, where 1 by v has replaced by psi nu psi beta of equation 3, and m I f is equal to this much. What is m I f? M I f is known as overlap integral between the wave function of initial and final nucleus, and is known only when the wave functions of initial and final states of nuclei are well known. The maximum value of MIF squared approximately equal to 1. In vector form beta decay theory, MIF is governed by Pauli spin operator sigma curve. Now we are going to find the value of statistical factor, that is dn by dt 0. For this, we write the total disintegration energy T0, total disintegration energy is equal to T nu plus T beta. For the neutrino of zero rest mass, P nu is equal to this one, and for beta it is electron, it is dP beta by is equal to dT0 by C. Now the volume element in momentum space from P nu to P nu plus dP nu, C here up to this p nu, and this is p nu plus dp nu. So the volume of in this momentum space range is 4 pi p nu square dp nu by 2 pi h by q by v. Similarly, the number of electron states, here a nu symbol indicates or stands for neutrino. Now we write the similar expression for beta, that is electron states. And if we multiply these two, we get the total. Hence, the total number of states in the interval dt0 will be C. But we do actually we get dn, we multiply for neutrino and for electron, means equation 14 multiplied by equation 15, then we get dn is equal to this one. On solving and arranging, we get dn by dt is equal to. This is not the final expression, because so far we have neglected Coulomb interaction, so we need to correct it, known as Coulomb correction. Now we see what is the effect of Coulomb interaction, which we have ignored earlier. And now we are going to consider. So far we have neglected the interaction between the nucleus and the emitted beta particle. The effect of this integration is that negatively charged particles are slowed down, while the positively charged particles are accelerated. Okay. And that is why when we consider the Coulomb interaction, we take the Coulomb correction factor Fz t beta. So here we write Fz t beta, which is equal to this one. The final expression will be P beta dP beta P. Actually, this one is the final expression. Okay. Now you can see here C square in the denoted C square C, it is C cube. And 2 pi square H7. Here H6, one H cut is here. Actually, it is not simple H. It is H is Planck's one, but here H cut means Planck constant divided by 2 pi, H by 2 pi. So this is the equation which we obtained, and this is the probability of transition, which in turn determines intensity of beta particle. Thank you. I hope you have understood this video. If you feel any problem, you may ask through WhatsApp or Telegram. Okay. Thank you.